Welcome back into Daytime Alabama. You've heard about IQ and even emotional IQ, but what about relational IQ? Joining me right now is Van Moody, who's the pastor of the Worship Center here in town, but also author of a brand new book, and it's called The People Factor. Thank you so much for joining us. We appreciate it.
It's good to see you. Here.
Okay, The People Factor, what is that?
Well, The People Factor is my new book, and the gist of the book is that there are no neutral relationships. That every relationship you have influences you in some way. What I've learned through the years of leading people, working with businesses, and even counseling individuals is that the right relationships can propel you to heights of great achievement and excellence and success, while the wrong relationships will keep you tethered to mediocrity and disappointment for the rest of your life. And so the people factor helps individuals understand how to navigate through what I call the landfill or minefield of relationships. Historical and even contemporary examples have shared a number of things about how damaging relationships can be, whether it's Tiger Woods, whether it's Paula Deen, whether it's Arnold Schwarzenegger. There are so many examples historically and contemporarily about the fact that you can be talented, you can be skilled, you can be in a number of areas, but if you don't understand how to handle relationships, professional relationships and personal relationships, they can be your undoing. And so the people factor helps people to understand how to raise their relational IQ, because relationships are an art. Mm-hmm. And what I've learned is that most people don't have the skill or the understanding to handle relationships appropriately.
Mm-hmm. So we all have individuals in our lives that are just a little bit difficult to get along with.
Yeah.
Now, in my mind, I'm thinking grace. There's grace when we're dealing with those individuals. What is your thought?
Well, obviously, we have to apply grace, but I think a better way to handle that is to understand that this is the principle that I've got to apply in this particular relationship. Mm-hmm. It's really important, and I talk about this in the book, to understand how to have healthy relationships with difficult people. Mm-hmm. Sometimes in the workplace, you're forced to do that. There's an old saying that says that you can choose your friends, but you can't choose your family. Mm-hmm. Well, in the workplace, oftentimes, you can't even choose your coworkers. Mm-hmm. And so that presents a challenge for many individuals. How do I have a healthy relationship with a toxic person? How do I make sure that even in the workplace that I can be effective without being affected by that individual's negativity or their baggage or some of their other things that they try to thrust on me by virtue of the working relationship that we have?
Do you think too often people take the victim role, or are there genuinely some people who are victims and need to remove themselves from those situations?
Oh, without a doubt. There are situations where people often are victimized in bad relationships, and they've got to learn the lessons. They've got to learn, number one, how to identify toxic relationships, but then also, what are the steps that they need to follow in order to remove themselves from the relationship? But some of the larger questions that I tackle in the book is, how do you even understand when a relationship is going wrong? Mm-hmm. What are the telltale signs that a relationship is changing? Mm-hmm. How do you maintain a healthy relationship, whether it's personal or professional? All of these are rules and laws and principles that I've learned are transferable and can apply to every relationship, but people have got to learn them and be able to apply them to their lives. And that's really the focus of the people factor.
And yet we're all accountable for our own actions, and
very
don't need
so.
To be pointing a finger at our past and using
exactly.
it as an excuse also. Well, it sounds fascinating. It's The People Factor, and it's actually not going to be on shelves until January, right? This is produced by Thomas Nelson.
Thomas Nelson, the largest publishing
they
house in the world.
They contacted you to do this.
They did, and we're excited about it. So it will release on January 7th, but between now and January 7th, we're doing a number of pre-orders. The book is available now for pre-order, Amazon, Barnes & Noble, anywhere the books are sold, even on our website, vanmoody.com.
Okay.
And we have a lot of incentives and bonuses for people that don't wait until the book is out. If they go ahead and pre-order now, they can receive all of those things.
I think you're going to have a lot of interest.
Well, I'm hoping so.
Again, it's The People Factor by Van Moody. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Good to see you. I appreciate it. And stay with us. We'll be right back with more Daytime Alabama.